Hey everyone, welcome to the 8th part of React Native Video Calling App tutorial. In this part of tutorial, we will convert our web client to a mobile client, that is a mobile client for React Native. So we won't make much of the changes. All the logic and most of the functions will be same, and we just have to make it work in a React Native way. So let's see what changes we have to done. So first we have to create a React Native app, and then we have to install React Native a few packages that we will be using for our new mobile client. So we need to install Socket.io, and then we need to install Lodash. So Socket.io will help us to make our React Native app work as a client for the video calling app server, and Lodash will help us to do some manipulation, array related manipulation and object related manipulation. So once we have installed these two packages, then we will need to port the code that we have done in web client to the React Native app. So let's see how we have done that, because I have this ready to go. So I will just explain you things. So first thing, that we have added all these components. We have added these components because the main thing that we need to replace is the HTML controls that we have used. Like we have used their text box for taking inputs and buttons. So here also we will use similar controls, which is actually called components in React Native. So we are using text input component, we are using button component, and we were using JavaScript conform a method to prompt user, and here we are using alert component to prompt user when the call is there. So here you can see we have made a connection to the server, and this is a bit different. The syntax is a bit different from there. Here we have to mention the port number and the IP address. There we didn't have to do that. Okay, apart from that, if you see here we have all those same variables that have been used in a web app: username, busy, in call with, and these functions, on login functions, call accept function, these are same as it was there. So let's see where is the difference. We have used HTML style of coding. Here we are using React Native style of coding, and React Native style of coding is by creating components. So here we have created a video calling app component. Okay, and we have created a constructor. In the constructor, we are initializing the states. Okay, these are all things related to React Native. If you have a basic knowledge of React Native, you can understand this quite well. Okay, on component did mount, we are initializing this video calling app this to global this, so that we can use underscore global this in the functions which are outside the video calling app. Okay, apart from that, this on press login is called when user presses the call button, user presses the login button. Okay, and most of the other things are same, and here I have theoretically written down all the basic changes that we have to make. Okay, so That's it. Most of the logic you will find same, and if you know React Native, you can quickly understand what we have done here. Okay, one more thing I would like to highlight here, that there we were copying the when any user logs in, then we used to copy the username to make a call. Here we don't have to do that, because in real life, real world app, user won't copy from console. So here we have used list view, and whenever a new user logs in, then the username is automatically added to every user, every client's, or every user's list. So user can see all the users logged in, and whenever any new user comes, that is also displayed. When a user suddenly gets disconnected, he is automatically removed from the list. So that the user is able to know that which all users are present in the video calling room. Okay, so that's it. And then user is in a similar way able to make calls like he was able to do before, and he's also able to receive calls, and that's it. So now we will go ahead and see things in action.